Welcome to a lesson on problem solving using addition and subtraction of whole numbers. More specifically, our goals are to interpret a pie chart and then answer questions using addition and subtraction. Here we see a pie chart that represents an individual's monthly expenses broken into categories. The categories are rent, food, transportation, school, and entertainment. And a pie chart is a nice way to represent because it gives a visual of how much of the total each category represents, in this case, for monthly expenses. So this blue color here represents the rent, and this individual spends $600 a month on rent. Let's go ahead and label that. The red region represents the amount of money spent on food per month, which is $250. So notice how that the piece of the pie that represents $600 is more than twice the size of the piece of pie that represents the monthly expense of food. Transportation expenses is in green and it represents $325. This purple region here represents school expenses, which is $575 a month. And this piece here represents entertainment expenses per month of $150. So the first question asks, if these were your monthly expenses, how much will you need on a monthly basis to cover your expenses? So we'll have to sum all of these expenses to determine the total monthly expenses. So we'll have 600, 250, 325, 575, and 150. So we'll start by adding the ones column. So 0 plus 0 plus 5 plus 5 plus 0, that'll be 10. So we have a 0 in the ones column and we carry 1 to the tens column. So we have 1 plus 5, that's 6, plus 2, that's 8, plus 7, that's 15, plus 5, that would be 20. So we put a 0 in the tens column and carry 2 over to the hundreds column. So we have 2 plus 6, that's 8, plus 2 is 10, plus 3 is 13, plus 5 is 18, plus 1 is 19. So we have $1,900 or $1,900 of monthly expenses based upon the given information. So the next question asks, if you are currently bringing home $2,012 per month, can you cover your expenses? Well, 2012 is greater than 1,900, so yes, you can cover your expenses. And the next question is, can you save any money per month? Bringing home this much money per month with $1,900 of expenses. To determine how much you can save, we would take the amount earned per month, 2012, and subtract the monthly expenses, and this would give us how much we could save on a monthly basis. So 2 minus 0 would be 2, 1 minus 0 is 1. Here we could take 20 minus 19, or you may want to think of borrowing 1 from the 2, and then we'd have a 10 in the hundreds column. So 10 minus 9 would give us 1. In the thousands place value, we have 1 minus 1, which is 0. So we can save a total of $112 per month based upon the given information. Now let's take a look at one more question. If your education expenses increase to $700 per month and you get a roommate to pay half of the rent, do you have enough money per month? Let's first take a look at how much the education expenses have increased. It's increasing to an amount of $700 per month when currently it is $575 per month. So if the new amount is $700 and the old amount was $575, we can subtract to determine how much it has increased. Let's start by doing this. So we'll have to borrow from the 7, this will be a 6. This would be a 10, we're going to have to borrow from here to get enough in the ones column. So this will be a 9, this will be a 10. So 10 minus 5, that would be 5. 9 minus 7, that would be 2. And then 6 minus 5 would be 1. So it's an increase of $125. Remember, our total expenses before the increase was $1,900. So the new total for our monthly expenses would be $1,900 plus the increase of $125. Go ahead and add. So our new total per month is $2,025. We were also told we'd bring home $2,012 per month, which would not be enough to cover our new monthly expenses. So if you get a roommate that pays half of the rent, and the current rent is $600, well, half of $600 is $300, so your rental expense would decrease by $300, therefore decrease the total monthly expenses by $300. So if we take $2,025 and subtract $300 from this, this will give us the new monthly expense with the roommate. So 5 minus 0, that's 5. 2 minus 0 is 2. We'll go ahead and borrow from the 2, so we have 10 minus 3, that would be 7. And then 1 minus 0 would be 1. So the new total for monthly expenses would be $1,725, which is obviously less than your monthly take-home pay. Therefore, with the changes listed in this problem, you would still come in under budget. In fact, even though your education expenses have increased, since you now have a roommate, we can see here that we could actually save more money per month. Let's go ahead and determine what that monthly savings would be. We take the monthly income and subtract out the new monthly expenses. We can determine how much we could save per month given this new situation. So again, here we have to borrow from the 1. So this will be 12 minus 5, that'll be 7. And with the borrow again in the tens column, but there's 0 in the hundreds column, so we have to go all the way over to the thousands column. We'll borrow 1 here. This will become 10, but we're going to change it to 9 because we're going to borrow. And so now we have a 10 in the tens column. 10 minus 2 would be 8. 9 minus 7 would be 2. And then 1 minus 1 is 0. So now, with this new situation, we can actually save $287 per month, which is actually even better, as long as you can handle a roommate. I hope you found this example helpful. Thank you for watching.